A big part of oil pollution comes in smaller, more frequent incidents that are harder to spot. Finding methods to shorten the response time is crucial to mitigating the incident's impact. Rijkswaterstaat, Interreg Europe, CO1, the Dutch AI Coalition, and FruitPunch AI have come together to fight oil in waterways. In the AI Against Oil Spills Challenge, we'll apply machine learning to detect and classify oil spills in inland waterways, ports, and on open seas. We'll automate the detection, calculate the surface and volume of the spill, and classify the type of leaked oil.
Rijkswaterstaat is the government agency that is responsible for the quality of water in the main waters of the Netherlands. Unfortunately, spills with different substances are still happening on a weekly and sometimes daily basis. And most of those spills are small and mostly always only oil-like substances. Rapid imaging is necessary to plan an effective response strategy. And the sooner and the better the information about spill characteristics, the better potential impact can be assessed and the right resources can be deployed. So quick response can help avoid damage to the environment. For imaging, we already use drones, airplanes, satellites, but interpreting those images is still difficult, time consuming, and depends very on the person doing it. So you not always have the same picture. Oil is always difficult to detect on the surface. It's not always oil that you think you see. It can also be other substances or elk, or the shadow of the clouds. So it's not always oil. Also, it's difficult to estimate the amount of oil that has been spilled based on the cause of the oil. Our goal for this challenge is we aim to come up with more reliable ways of detecting oil spills and calculating the volumes on the water so that response teams can choose the best resources and methods. And as a last resource, a closer estimation of the dispersions that they need to use. And as a bonus, we can build up data of spills over time to gain a better understanding of different response options, including dispersion agents, and effectiveness on real spills. So what would be for me personal a good result? I would already be happy when we could automatically detect oil spills on the water surface with a camera on a drone. This is not only a great challenge to develop your skills, but you also contribute on a better environment. I think this challenge will not help only to improve the environment and the water quality in the Netherlands, but can also help the spills response community worldwide gain a better understanding of the effectiveness of the techniques.
We'll accept applications for this challenge until August 14th or until we reach 50 participants. The challenge itself runs from August 15 until October 24. A masterclass on oil spill response will bring you up to speed. Experience with computer vision, satellite data, and model optimization would help a lot, but if you're ready to work hard and learn, basic Python knowledge is enough to join. We're looking forward to working with you.